I'm here with one of the best pound-for-pound MMA fighters, King Mo. Andre Ward, a lot of people consider him the pound-for-pound king of boxing. Sergey Kovalev, right up there. What do you think?
You know what? Battle of Titans, but I got Ward.
Why?
I just think he's too all-rounded. He has too many ways to win the fight. What's up, coach? The only way Kovalev is really going to win is by knocking him out, I feel like. I think Ward can outwork him. I think Ward can outslick him. I think Ward can beat him on the inside. I think Ward's going to be stronger than what he expects. I think Ward's going to make a miss. You haven't really seen Kovalev in there with any real slicksters. Only slickster you've seen him in there with was...
B-Hop. He won that fight, but he didn't stop B-Hop like he stopped everybody else.
Let's be real.
B-Hop's 51, B-Hop. Yeah.
And Ward is a younger, upgraded version of B-Hop, in my opinion.
People tell me that Ward is part Floyd, part B-Hop, and part Roy Jones Jr.
That's what he is. But I remember when I met Ward in the Olympic Training Center in 2004, and all he talked about was Roy Jones Jr. That's all he talked about. And then he tried to fight like Roy Jones, and he got dropped by Darnell Boone. What's up, Darnell Boone? Diesel, One Punch Man. It's my dog. And then, what's up, coach?
What's up, Rafa? How you feeling?
How are you?
Good to see
you.
I'm good.
This is my man.
Hey. How's everything? Good?
Everything good. K.O. Bueno, he knocked him out of the guy in the first round.
Good job. Congratulations. Yeah. Or he will. Is that your prediction or did that happen?
No, he just happened.
Oh, okay. Yeah. The accent.
Yeah.
Okay, I miss you, man.
Always. Good talk. Puerto Rico.
I saw him. He started rebuilding, you know. HBO got rid of him. Showtime got rid of him. I saw him. He's fighting on Fox, FS1 back in the day,
true.
Fox Sports. And then I remember I was watching him, and all of a sudden, he had to fight Ace Miranda. And I was like, whoa, that's Miranda, no joke, man.
No, he was.
He went out there and handled him. And then I think that's the fight that was the breakout fight that made people realize, I'm one of the top guys. You know what I'm saying?
You're a huge boxing fan.
Yeah.
Knowing that you know a lot of these fighters personally, you've met a lot of them. What's it like for you, like, to watch them fight?
Yeah, I enjoy it. You know what I'm saying? I'm a boxing fan. I love boxing. I love these boxers. I want to see them all succeed, even though they all can't. There's gonna be some failures in there, but I grew up watching, it's something I love. And if I can meet them, it's a great thing for me. You know what I'm saying?
Give me your top three favorite fighters to watch right now, active.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It's a tough one, you know, but I like Caleb Plant.
He's a beast.
Sweet hands. Tevin Farmer.
Tevin's a beast, too. He's cool. He's
Errol
really
Spence,
cool.
J-Rock, you know. I have a long list, you know. It's just I like watching Lomachenko, Ward, you know. Nicholas Walters. Naoya Inoue is going to beat Roman Gonzalez. If he play out there like
that's
that
a guy. If he beats Chocolatito, is he pound-for-pound king?
No, Ward is.
Okay, but that would be a huge win. But that's a fight we want to see with only 9 fights.
Yeah, it'll happen.
Chocolatito has like 48 fights or something like that. No, sorry, 44 or 45 fights.
45, so 46, something like that. But I'm waiting for that fight to happen. It'll happen probably next year, a year or two.
All right, there you have it. King Mo, look out for him. King Mo FH on Twitter. FuseNewsPoint.com. I'm Melissa Back reporting.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Eli Sekpak.